Welcome to the Jongets Games tutorial and playthrough for Tapestry. In this video, I'll be showing you how to play the game while we're actually playing it, and if you'd like to watch the rest of the playthrough, you can do so by clicking the link for it down below in the description, or you can click the I up there in the top corner. Now before we move on, I would like to ask that you please turn on the Klingon subtitles. That way, if I make any mistakes, I can then put corrections directly on the screen, and you should be able to see them. Now before we move on, I also want to mention that the only reason this video is being made is because it won the monthly Patreon poll that is voted on by the supporters of this channel. If you'd like to learn more about that, you can go to patreon.com/jongetsgames to see how you could potentially vote in future polls. Now, let's talk about Tapestry itself. What is going on in this game is each player is in charge of a civilization. Now, there are 16 different types of civilizations that you can use in each game, and they will definitely change the way one game is going to play to the next. Now, on a player's turn, they can either advance up 4 different tracks, or they can take income, which is going to give them the resources and whatnot that they need for their empire. And as you go up those tracks, you will have the ability to explore new lands, conquer those lands. You can also learn science and technologies, which will give you a variety of benefits, and there's just a lot going on in this game, and I'll explain the details of all of this once we get to it. Now, before we jump into the game, I would like to ask that if you enjoy this video, you please click the like button for it down below, as well as the subscribe button for the channel. Also, if you would like to directly support this channel in the creation of future videos like this one, then please go to jongetsgames.com/support. There you'll find a bunch of ways that you can help things out, and some of them have pretty cool bonuses like voting on a couple of the videos that I film each month, and again, this is one of those videos. Alright, let's jump into the game. Out here, the game is fully set up and ready to play for our 3 different players. Today, we will be playing from the perspective of the blue player right over here, and at the start of the game, we all got to draw 2 of these civilization boards and then choose one of them. Well, today it looks like we will be the leader's civilization, the yellow player has the merrymakers, and lastly, the red player is the architects. Well, I figure at this point we may as well begin playing, and we are the starting player. That means we can take the first turn of the game, and the way you take your turn is you have to decide one of 2 options. The first is you can take an income turn, and the second option is you can do an advanced turn. Now, I'll tell you right now that all of the advanced actions require resources, and at the start of the game, everybody has 0 resources. That means for our first turn and the first turn of both of our opponents, we will have to do an income action. So let's focus in on our board, and you'll notice over here this says income turn. Now there are up to 4 things that you will do with an income action, and the way you figure out which ones you do has to do with what income this is throughout the game. Now we're going to take 5 income actions, and this is currently our first. That means we can look over and only evaluate the bottom section, because that's the only one that has a 1 in it. Now this action specifically says we can take our income, and I'll explain what the other 3 things are when we do our second income action. So let's focus out a little bit, and the way this bottom action works is we just take everything that is face up on these areas at the top of our board. Each one of these is an income building, and as we build them out, we will generate more income. So at the start of the game, we have just the leftmost option available for all of these, and you'll start off by noticing that on each track, there is a different symbol. Now these are the resources in the game. We have culture, food, population, and money, and down here at the bottom of our board, you can see we have tokens for all of those. So that means we can generate 1 of each of those, bring in these right over here, and you'll notice that you can store up to 8 of each of these resources. Next up, on the right side of our board, you'll notice that in addition to getting a food for farming, we also get 1 of these exploration tiles. Now we take it randomly from the top, and then we put it face up so that everyone can see it. Lastly, if we look down here, in addition to getting a culture with our armories, we also get a tapestry card. As you can see, there is a deck of them right up here, so we can just draw the top one, and then put this into our hand. Alright, that has finished our first turn of the game, so now we can go clockwise over to the yellow player, and they also have to take an income because they have no resources. So just like us, they will get 1 of each resource, they will take a tapestry card, and they will take a terrain tile. And then finally, the red player will do the same. Well, it's now time for our second turn of the game, and unlike the first turn, we now have resources to spend. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and take an advancement turn. Now, in order to do this, we have to come out here to the main board. As you can see, there are 4 of these tracks that go along the outside, and each player starts with 1 of their tokens over here in the leftmost spot. Now, when you take an advance action, you simply choose 1 of your 4 tokens, and you move it once along that track. Now, you'll notice that these tracks are split up into 4 overall sections, and each one has a cost printed up along the top. So you'll see that the first section along each of these tracks says, as a cost, you have to spend 1 of the 4 resources to move into the next zone. Well, for our first turn, I think let's move down the technology track. So we can take our token right here and move it into the next slot. And we immediately have to spend one of any of the resources. And in this case, I think we'll spend a population. Now, at the start of the game, it doesn't really matter which one of these resources you spend, considering the beginnings of all of those tracks can take any of the resources. But as we go farther down them, each track is specialized on one of the four resource types. All right, we can now take the action for this spot, and it says pottery. Now, all we have to do is take a technology card. We can grab any of the three that are face up right now, or we could take one that's face down on top of the deck. And no matter what card we take, we won't actually get any benefit for right now. We are just planning for the future when we end up investing in those technologies. Now, I think right at the start of the game, let's take this Zeppelin card, and then we can immediately replace this spot on the track. Next up, we can add this into our playing area, and you'll notice we put it down on the bottom slot. You can see this X means you don't get the benefit for this technology, but once we're able to move it right up here, then we'll get the benefit within the circle because you can see this matching circle. Once this gets up to the top, then you get the benefit for the square, and they are always going to be immediate one-shot benefits that you take. Now, the way you move this card up involves a upgrade action, and we actually have that symbol showing right here on our territory tile, so I'll explain that in more detail once we get there. All right, we are now done with our turn, so the yellow player can go, and they've decided to move up on this exploration advancement track. Now, this is going to cost them one of their resources, and they're going to spend this money, and then they can take the benefit of scouting. Now, all this does is lets them draw two more of these tiles right here, so they can put them face up in their area, and they now have three of these available for when they do end up exploring out on the map, which is probably going to happen rather soon. At this point, the red player can go, and they've decided to advance up on the science track. So they're going to go right over here, and they have to spend one of their resources, and they're going to get rid of this culture right here. Next up, they can take this astronomy action, and the way this works is they're going to roll this die right here, and then they have the option of advancing up once on the spot that shows. Now, they will not get any benefits that are showing on that spot, so we can see right here, if they want to, they can now take a free technology advancement. So we can come over here, and that would bring them to the spot, but again, remember, they won't get the action on this spot, and that means they won't pick up a technology card, but they figure they're okay with this. Well, that's going to finish out their turn, which means we can now take our next turn, and I think we want to move down this technology track again. So that means we can move this right over here, and we once again have to spend one of our resources, and this time we'll spend a culture. Next up, we can do this action for carpentry here, and this icon means we get to draw another tapestry card, and down below there is a bonus. Now, this is an optional thing. If we spend the associated thing over here, then we get the benefit down here. Now, in this case, that means we could spend one more resource in order to place one of our merchant income buildings. Now, I do think we want to do that, but we can start off by drawing the tapestry card. So we can draw that tapestry card from right over here and add it into our hand. Now, we, of course, drew one as part of our first income action, and these cards are important because in future income actions, we are actually going to choose one of them to play down here onto our board. As you can see, there are three different spots that can take them, so throughout the game, we are going to play three of these tapestry cards, so let's now take a look at the details of them. This one right here says Boast of Superiority, and it says when you play this, then you check each one of the advancement tracks, and for each one where nobody is farther than you, you gain 4 points. So that means if you are tied for farthest or farthest on all four tracks, this card right here would give you 16 points. Now, in general, a good score in this game will be higher than 200, so 16 is important, but not, you know, the biggest thing in the world. Now, over here, the other one we have now says Monarchy, and this one's a little bit different. It says this era instead of when played. Now, when played is instantaneous, but this era means this effect will go into play until the following income action. So this says whenever you place an income building in your capital city, you get 3 points. So these are both things that we are considering as we take more actions into the future. So at this point, it's now time to construct one of our income buildings, and specifically that's going to be one of our markets. Now we do have to spend one of our resources in order to do this, so I figure we'll spend a food, and now we can take our leftmost market and place it down into our capital city. As you can see, ours is in the grassland, and it is a 9x9 grid. Now, there are these spots with dots on them, and those are impassable terrain, so we can put this down onto any spot except for those. Now, we have two things that we are keeping in mind as we place this down. The first is, whenever we complete one of these 3x3 sections, then we immediately get a bonus resource of our choice, which is certainly important considering resources give us actions. Now, the other thing to consider is as soon as you have rows and columns made in your area, you will start to generate more points during income. As you can see with this icon up here, that means you will get 1 point for every complete row and column, including those impassable terrain spots within your overall capital city. So as we get more of these out, you'll notice you can actually score this multiple times, which might be something we want to focus on. So we can see down here in the grasslands, we have a nice little river delta going on over here. So I figure let's put this right onto that spot. That way, just three more spots exist in this 3x3 area, so we are working towards getting that bonus, and it looks like there's just 1, 2, 3, 4 more spots available in this row to start trying to generate points from that. Now, I did call this an income building, and the reason for that is because now that we've removed this, the next time we do an income action, you'll notice we're going to make another one of the money resource. Down below, we can see we've unlocked currency in addition to bartering that we started the game with. All right, the yellow player can go again, and they've decided they also want to move down the same track they started on. Now, this is going to cost them one of their resources, and they're going to spend this culture right here, and now they have the ability to do exploration. When we focus in a bit more, you'll notice they also have the option of spending another resource to draw another tapestry card, but it looks like they are not going to do that. So they can now do this exploration action, which lets them place one of their region tiles down onto the board. So let's come out to the board, and in particular, we'll focus on the yellow player's starting capital city. You'll notice that's right here with these two tokens on it, and whenever you explore out, you have to go onto an area that has not been explored yet that is also adjacent to a region that you control. Now, you control a region if you have a standing up pillar on it, so they can put this down into any one of these three spots, and they've decided they're going to put it just like that. Now, as soon as you place this down, you'll score points for it, and you do this by looking at the edges. As you can see, many of the edges are kind of half occupied. For instance, this spot has half water and it has half grassland. Over here, this is half forests and then half water and then some water over here. Now, every one of the sides of the newly placed tile that matches at least half of the terrains up is going to get a point. So that means they'll get 1 point for here because there's water and water. Right here, that's another point for water, water. There's water and water matching over there for a third point. And finally, forest to forest for a fourth point for the yellow player. So they're going to take the first points of the game, bringing them up to 4. After you've scored the tile, the next thing that happens is you take the benefit that's showing in the middle. So in this case, the yellow player can take one culture resource. This means they now have one of those, and they've now finished out their turn. All right, it's now the red player's turn, and they appear to be following us down the technology track. We can see this lets them draw another tapestry card, and they are going to spend an additional resource to get a market down. They, of course, have to spend a resource just to do the action, so that is 2 resources total. And in this case, they're going to spend a money and a food, and then they're going to put this income building down onto that spot in their desert capital city. Now, it's worth noting they are the architects, and their special abilities have to do with their capital city. Let's go ahead and focus in over here, and it says that the architects value an organized and structured capital city. So every time they complete one of their districts, which is the 3x3 areas in their capital city, if all of the income buildings within that spot are identical, they get +1 resource, so they get 2 instead of 1. Now, they have to have at least one income building within that area to make that happen. Also down here, it says every time they do a capital city scoring, if all of the income buildings in the row or column are the same, then they get 2 points for that row or column instead of 1. All right, it's now our turn, and if we wanted to, we could of course do an advance action. We have 1 resource to spend currently, but instead we could do our second income action of the game. Now remember, when you do that, you're going to do all of these options right over here, and as a benefit, if you are the first among your specific neighbors to do an income for that specific spot, then you get the bonus that's listed right over here. That icon means you are your neighbors, and we can tell in a 3-player game, obviously that means being the first person total. Now the first person to go into an income of the second one gives 1 bonus resource. There's 2 bonus resources for the first person to do their third income, and 3 bonus resources for the first person to do their fourth income action. So we could take an income action right now to get that bonus resource, but I think instead we are going to spend this money because that's going to let us get another income building out, which means we'll get more income when we do an income action, most likely next turn. So we've already paid for it, which means we can now go right over here, and this spot lets us either take another technology, or we could take another one of the market income building. Now, I think that is what we want to do, but before we get there, there's something else I'd like to talk about, and that involves this symbol right here. Now, as I said before, every one of the tracks is split up into 4 sections, and the first spot in the second, third, and fourth section involves a silhouette of a landmark. Now, the one for this spot right here is this one, and the first person to get to that spot in the track can immediately take this landmark and put it down into their capital city. Now, it reacts just like the income buildings as far as covering up spaces. So we could use this to fill in a 3x3 district to get bonus resources, or we could use it to fill in rows and columns. I suppose, realistically, that could go towards both of those benefits. And this first one covers up a 2x2 grid. So I do think it's important to keep working down this track, considering the red player is kind of chasing us, because I want to be the first person to get here and take this landmark. Now, before we move on, I also want to mention that there's a landmark hanging out over here. Now, sure, there are a bunch of landmarks that you get for being the first person to get to these spots on these tracks, but you can also get landmarks of differing sizes from these technologies. For instance, this library can turn into an actual library that goes down into your capital city that covers up a 2x4 grid. So let's now take this action, and we are going to place another market income building, and I figure we'll put it right over here. At this point, the yellow player can go, and they have 3 resources available to them. After looking over their options, they've decided to move up to the first spot on the military track, which is archery. Now, with this, they can now do a conquer action, which is what this symbol means. But they, of course, do have to spend 1 resource of their choice. In this case, they're going to give up a population. Now they can perform their conquer action, and the way this works is they're going to choose 1 space that is adjacent to a spot that they control, and they're going to conquer it. Now the only restriction here is they have to conquer an actual region area. You can't conquer the gray area on the board, and you cannot conquer an area that has 2 pieces in it already. So what that means is they could conquer this spot, or that spot over here, and let's just say the red player happened to teleport over to that location. That means they could also conquer this location because there was just 1 piece in that spot. Now, as soon as that happens, they would simply topple over the red player, and they would then control this area, and that means for the rest of the game, nobody can conquer over here because now there are 2 pieces in this spot. Now, there is 1 type of tapestry card called trap cards that could change this up. If in this case, when the yellow player came in, the red player revealed this card right here, which says trap, then immediately the yellow player would actually be the one to get toppled, the red player would get a bonus resource, and the red player would now permanently control this area for the rest of the game. So you do have to be a little bit careful when you're trying to take over areas with your opponents. You have to take a look and see how many of these tapestry cards they have in their hand, and if you want to risk it. Now, obviously, this is just an example. In this case, the yellow player decides they do want to conquer this island right here. Now, as soon as you do that, the player has to roll these conquer dice. There's a red one that has victory point symbols on them, and there's this one right here that has some other benefits. So what the player does is they roll both of them, and they choose one of them for their bonus. So in this case, they can take 6 victory points or 1 of the money resource. Now, 6 points is quite a lot, but the yellow player decides they want to take the money instead. Now, it is worth noting there are a couple other options. For instance, this spot right here means you get the benefit of the location you just conquered, and over here, this is going to give you a number of points equal to the number of spots that you control. So right now, that would just be 2 for the yellow player. But either way, they are now going to take their money resource, and that has finished out their conquer action. This means they've gone back up to 1. Now, before we move on, I think it's time to talk about these achievements down here. Each one is effectively a race that each player is competing in. This first one says complete any advancement track, and that means the first time somebody gets to the very end of one of the 4 tracks, they can put a token down over here and get 10 points, and the second time that happens, that player will get 5 points. The next achievement right here says topple 2 opposing outposts. So this means if out here you control 2 regions that have an opponent's toppled tower, then if you're the first person, you get 10 points, and if you're the second person, you get 5. Now the last one says conquer the middle island, and it says 10 points and 5 points, and that simply means the first person to conquer this island right here gets 10, and if somebody else comes in and conquers that away from the first person, then that person will get 5 points. Now at this point, I also want to mention that currently we are playing on the 1-3 player board, and if this was a 4 or 5 player game, we would flip this over, the map would be larger, and these achievements would pay out to the third person as well. Alright, it's the red player's turn, and they have 1 resource, and they also see that we have no resources. That means we have to take an income action on our next turn, so if they did an income action right now, they would get a bonus resource. Now that does seem tempting to them, but instead, they're going to advance up on a track. And the reason for that is because if they go over here, they can now get a technology. Now, as part of the income actions, you can upgrade technology, and they would like to have one of these before they go into their first income. And remember, they skipped over this action right here with their astronomy action over from the science track. So in this case, they've decided to take one of these technologies right here, and they're going to go with irrigation. After that, we can draw a new one from the top of the deck, and it looks like this is the treasury. And this is another one that gives a landmark if it's upgraded to its second spot. So the red player can add this down here and, of course, spend one resource for that action. And they're hoping this is worth it. They figure when they get this upgraded as part of their income, they're going to get a resource anyway. And they do want to work towards getting more of these income buildings out. All right, it's now time for our turn, and we have no resources. So that means it's time to take our second income action of the game. Now, the way this works is we can once again come back over here, and the first option activates on the second, third, fourth, and fifth income. Now, what this means is we can check over here to our leaderboard and see if there's anything applicable that happens. In this case, it does, so let's focus in down here. We can see here it says that the leaders excel at cultivating leadership abilities of their citizens. Now, it says at the beginning of your second, third, fourth, and fifth incomes, you may place a player token down onto an uncovered leader square over here. Now, this lets you advance for free on the corresponding track. You get the benefit, but you do not get any bonus on that spot. Now, in this case, I figure let's go up that technology track one more time so that we can secure that landmark. So we can come back to the board and move on to this spot, which means we have indeed picked up this forge right here, and then we can do this action. Now this says if we want to, we could get rid of all three of these options, and then we can draw another technology, or we could just take one of these that's currently available. And I think I kind of like the idea of sewage and plumbing. It gives a culture the first time it's upgraded, and the second time it gives one of those income buildings, which is going to help us get more stuff when we do future incomes. So we can take this card right here and immediately refill the spot. Oh wow, looks like we've hit another one of these with the landmarks. This says Comm Tower, and the landmark for that one is a 2x3. So we can come down here and add this technology down to the bottom, and of course we can add our forge over here into our city. Now, if we wanted to, we could put it over here so that we are working towards trying to complete this row, but I think instead, let's put it down there. That's because we have immediately completed a 3x3 district, which means we can take one resource of our choice, and I think we're going to take probably a food. It's now time for the next bonus, and this says that we can play one of our tapestry cards. Now, in this case, it looks like at the moment we are only farthest on one track, so this boast of superiority does not seem good. It would just give us 4 points. So instead, let's play Monarchy. We can put this right over here, and it says that during this era, whenever we place an income building down into our capital city, we get 3 extra points. So I think that's something we are certainly going to focus on. Now, of course, when we put this down, we notice that we are the first of our neighbors to go into our second income, and that means we get a bonus resource. So I figure let's just spread things out a little bit, and we can take a culture. And now we can move on to the third of these options, which has this orange arrow. Now, that means we can move one of our technologies up one slot. And we currently have 2 technologies to choose from. Now, sewage and plumbing would give us an extra culture, and it means we would just be 1 upgrade away from getting another one of these buildings out. And of course, that would be good considering if we get it done this era, we get bonus points. However, I think instead, let's go with the Zeppelins. This benefit lets us move up once on the exploration track, and we do not get the benefit, but I don't really care about the first spot, which is called Scouting, and the reason for that is because I already like this tile. As you can see, it has an upgrade symbol on it, so I am planning on going over here to this action in the next era. That will let us put this down and get another upgrade action, and potentially we can move up this track over here to get a third one to try and get lots of stuff upgraded and get more of those income buildings done this round. So either way, we have now skipped over this spot, and that also lets us just get farther down this row without having to spend an entire turn and resources on it. The next thing we do is take all of the laurel points that are showing up here on our income tracks. You can see that we are going to get 2 points for each one of our technologies because 2 of that symbol shows up. We will get 1 point for every one of our rows and columns completed, and that is it for the laurels. As we can see, we have 2 of these technologies, so that's going to be 2 times 2, or 4 points, and we have completed no rows or columns yet, so that's 4 points total. This means we have now tied up with the yellow player, and it's now time to take the rest of our income. So we can see up here, that's going to give us 2 of the money resource. We will get 1 population, we will get 1 food, and we're going to get 1 culture. All right, that has finished out our second income action of the game, which means it's now time for the yellow player's next turn. But I think instead of going into that, it's now time to discuss how this game will end. Now, as I said before, we are all going to do 5 income actions throughout the game, and once you've finished your 5th income action, you will be done and you will have your final score calculated. There is no endgame victory point scoring, you just get points for the achievements and points that you get as you are playing throughout the game. Now, once you are done, you might have to wait a couple turns until your opponents finish up their 5th income, and at that point you check to see who has the most points, and that person will be the winner. So at this point, I have now taught you most of the general rules for Tapestry. Obviously, there are quite a few icons I haven't covered just yet, and I will explain those in detail once we get to them in the extended playthrough. So if you would like to watch that, you can find a link for it down below in the description, or you can click the I up there in the top corner, and I hope you've enjoyed learning how to play Tapestry.
As always, I'd like to thank everyone who's been supporting this channel, including all of these producer-level Patreon backers. If you too would like to directly support the channel and the creation of videos like this one, then please go to johngetsgames.com/support to see a variety of ways with which you could do that. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please click the like button down below as well as the subscribe button for the channel. Thanks for watching!